Last time on Let's Play Chrono Trigger! If looks could kill, you'd be lying on the floor. You'd be begging to please, please, baby, don't hurt me no more. If looks could kill, you'd be reeling from the pain. And you'd never lie again. If looks could kill, if looks could kill. And now, the continuation. If looks could kill, dun, 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 I would still be H.C. Bailey, dun, 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 and I'd still welcome you all back to Let's Play, dun, 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 Chrono Trigger! Man, I have a strange taste in music, don't I, viewers? Actually, I'll be honest with you, I'm more of a fan of the classical music, but it's not funny, so I don't play it in any of my videos. Okay, so let's see. Last time we got our equipment back and our money back, so all that's left are the items. All right. Okay, so yeah, here we are. All right, here it is. The final chest. We get our items back from Dalton, finally. So now, that door leads to the exit, but I don't want to go there quite yet. You know, this place is kind of cozy when you get used to it after a while. Yeah, I like what Dalton's done with the place here. Speaking of Dalton, you know, he's kind of like the Kefka of Chrono Trigger, you know? He starts out with mediocre powers at best and provides the comic relief for the villains. Except that Kefka eventually becomes infinitely more powerful than him. And he's just, well, playing better than him in general, you know. And Sephiroth, for that matter. Oh, I'm sorry, viewers. Well, I guess Sephiroth was kind of cool in Advent Children. So anyway, that magic tab I just collected there, you can only get that after you've gotten all your items and everything up, weapons and everything back. So, at least I think that's the way it works, so. Flip the switch if I can. There we go. Now, Kefka versus Golbez, that's a debate. That would be a hard one for me to call. I'd have to think about that one. Okay, now if you... Whoa. Now, okay, let's stop here. Now, if you haven't gotten all your items, someone will say, hey, you know, we forgot some stuff back there or whatever. I think someone said in the comments that we can actually get them all back afterwards anyway, but I've never done that. I've always gotten all my items back. So now we're out on the wings, and somehow we're not falling off. So we got these turrets right here, and they're basically the same thing as, what are those guys? The rubbles. Except I think they're even harder to kill, but you get a ton of tech points for killing them. So I'm going to take my time and try and take them all out. So let's do it. Yeah, those guys give you 100 tech points each, so that's pretty good. We really need them. Let's see, I think there's a couple more around here somewhere. Yeah, there they are. One, whoa, that's a lot of them. One at a time. Let's get this one up here, one at a time. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, these guys will actually attack you. So, not that it's anything to worry about, but. Okay, I just took a moment to heal up, so let's go and jump off the edge. Whoa! Man, there's a strong gust of wind coming up. What's causing that? Well, yeah, we kind of figured that out, Froggy. Oh no! It's another one of Dalton's golems. Okay, well, it's boss time. Literally, the golem boss. Best thing to do against this guy? Cube toss, leap slash. That's the way to go. I love this dual tech. Oh, I love the sound effect it makes. It sounds really painful. So yeah, this guy doesn't really do much of anything. I mean, does anyone know if he has like any attacks in his AI script at all? I don't understand, but okay, whatever. You gotta attack him to kill him, so I don't know what the idea is. So what was I thinking about before? Oh yeah, Kefka versus Golbez. Well, I love Golbez because he has the Darth Vader gear going on and the Sith lightning and everything, you know? I mean, imagine if Darth Vader could use Sith lightning. I mean, he'd be even more badass than he already is. And, I mean, Golbez has the theme clad in dark. I mean, it still gives me goosebumps to this day. But that said, I'd still have to give the edge to Kefka for the same reason that I'd give the edge to Jack Nicholson's Joker over Heath Ledger's Joker. I mean, granted, Golbez is one of, if not the most epic villain in all of Final Fantasy games. But Kefka is just so much more fun to watch. I mean, as evil and insane as he is, I mean, he's just so silly and stupid at the same time. He's just the best. You're not going to beat Kefka. Oh god, did I just diss Sephiroth and Heath Ledger's Joker in the same video? Oh man, I'm in trouble now. I'm gonna get like 100 hate mails now, aren't I, viewers? Oh well. I've never been afraid of controversy. Now, this guy is apparently afraid of heights. I forget where they say that or not, but he's afraid of heights. That's why he never attacks us at all. It's just a waste of time, but okay. Whatever, game. Eureka! Anytime I have a chance to say that word, I love it. Wow, he put wings on our wings of time. Okay, fair enough. I guess maybe Balthazar never got around to it. Stop the music! Cut! Cut! Can someone tell me what the dialogue was for this in the Japanese version? I can't imagine it's this silly. We have liftoff, Houston! Whoa! That thing can even fly now. Well, I suppose that's why I put the wings on it, but man. How are we gonna stop him now? Well, yeah, I kinda saw that. What are you gonna do about it, huh? Make like a tree and leave. Whoa, he even put weapons on that thing. What are we gonna do? Huh? He wasn't the one who killed Chrono. He just, like, made, like, chicken ran. But, yeah. He was pretty smart, actually, about that. Okay, well, Dalton. Okay, I guess he has a few new attacks, but basically he's had the same HP as before, so a couple cube tosses and leap slashes, and that should do the trick. Oh, yeah, he can copy your attacks, but he does the opposite now. But still, I wouldn't worry about it. Our HP is doing really well now at this point. I don't think I'll ever be at risk for dying ever again in the rest of the game now because of that, so. Ow! Well, gotta watch out for his final attack, so. There we go, that should do it. I'm surprised that attack has so much damage to it. I mean, Rock Throw is pretty good, but Ice 2 really isn't that powerful. Golem Boss! Didn't you summon him earlier? They never really did quite explain that, because apparently. Okay, he's getting sucked into the dead zone now. But yeah, I mean, what happened earlier? Did, like, the golem boss escape or something? Or did he summon him and then forget about it? I think the golem boss escaped from wherever he was summoned from. But whatever. What are we gonna do now? Try the Y button. Oh! Hey, alright, we're hitting the Blackbird. Does it have any weapons? No! And by the way, we never see Dalton ever again. That's it. He gets sucked into the dead zone, and that's it. No more Dalton. Yay! And the Blackbird is going down. Where does that thing take off from anyway? I mean, there's no runways around here. There's no room for one. Yeah, we got him. And we can fly around the world just like an airship. All right. No, we're not in his debt. He put on wings. He stole our machine. He got vaporized. I don't care how strong you are. You're not surviving that. Okay, well, that's all for this episode of Let's Play Chrono Trigger. Next time, we'll see what we're going to do next. This is HC Bailey signing off. Have a good day.